in today's episode, we're gonna do something very special. It's actually one of my favorite dishes. It's a roasted chicken, but it's inspired by the Ritz-Carlton down here in sunny South Florida. And they do this at the Ritz-Carlton. This is my interpretation of what they do at the Ritz-Carlton. I'm gonna walk you through a couple of ingredients that are in it. We have some Swiss chard. We have some corn. It's gonna be a bean and corn salsa. We have all different seasonings and flavors that are gonna go throughout the process. We have polenta that actually goes on the bottom of the dish at the end. And of course, we gotta get the main ingredient, which has been in a salt bath for a couple of hours, and that's the roasted chicken. This is a whole chicken cut in half, and we're gonna season this up. Now, as you know on this show, it's not just about the food, it's about the music. And one of the big things that's coming down the pipe right now, which I'm a big fan of, is James Bond. So we're gonna do a little music tribute, and we're gonna go ahead and start it with this. Let's go. So this process right here is preparing the marinade that's gonna go actually on the chicken. And these are the ingredients that are gonna be in the chicken. They've all been prepared before. I'm gonna put all of this in the recipe within the ad, but not in the ad, but within the video. But you have Italian parsley, onion, garlic, cayenne pepper, oregano, a red wine sauce, olive oil, black pepper, and salt. All of that right there actually makes the marinade that we're gonna actually put the chicken in now that it has been rested with a salt bath for a day. And we're gonna let that marinate in that chicken for about 2 to 4 hours. If you really wanna get the flavor going, give it 24 hours. But if you have guests coming and you wanna do it a little bit quicker, an hour to 2 hours, 2 hours is really probably where you need to be. So let's get started. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take all of the Italian parsley. Onions. Drop that in there real nice. The garlic. Little bit of that spice with the cayenne pepper. And of course, some oregano. You're gonna season that up there. And then I'm gonna break in this next section. I'm gonna mix this up a little bit before I add the olive oil and the wine and the black pepper and the salt. But you just mix that in there real nice. Man, it smells fabulous already, and I haven't even really put it on anything yet. So we're gonna keep that going, and we're gonna evolve to the next step. About the marinade, you can come here and get a zoom in and you can kind of see the ingredients. But now we're going to add a cup of olive oil. You can use olive oil. Some people use avocado oil. I'm using olive oil in this instance. Avocado oil doesn't burn with the same level of consistency as olive oil does, but that's what I'm using here. And then I'm gonna use a half a cup of the red wine vinegar. Very important here to the top. We are at half a cup. And that gives you a nice flavor profile for this marinade. Just mix that in there. What's your favorite James Bond movie? like a whole bunch of them. Moonraker was dope. And I could go on, but who was your favorite James Bond character? Then we got some sea salt. I'm gonna sprinkle to taste, but remember there was a nice brine bath that we gave to the chicken, so I wouldn't overdo it with the salt, but I put a little bit in here, and I'm just gonna do it to taste. I'm just gonna do two for me right now, and if it needs a little bit of salt later, I'll add it. I'm just trying to keep the sodium low, but it does give the flavor. And then last but not least is some black pepper. Crack that up as much as you want. I'm gonna keep it cracking. And you just stir that up. And that is your marinade that's gonna go on the celebrity for the hour, which is the roasted chicken. And this is the finished product. The smell right now of this, oh my goodness. This just smells. It smells really, really good. That's all I can say. I'm gonna just say it with that. So while you're getting your playlist together for what your favorite James Bond stuff is, I'm gonna go ahead and get ready for this next step. I'll see you soon. So, as I'm listening to the whole James Bond theme song, I'm on a playlist right now, whether you're on Apple Music or Spotify or however you get your music, that's it. Right now, Skyfall was a good one. So we're gonna go to this next step. I'm gonna pull the host of the show, which is the about to be roasted chicken. And we have these two marinades. I'm gonna transfer this from here, but I haven't had it dry to take that salt bath that it was sitting in for the last 24 hours. So it's been in a salt bath for the last 24 hours, and the reason why I'm doing that is to suck all of everything out, and it's actually gonna make that skin get a lot crispier when I roast it. So you just pat it dry, because that salt in that brine bath pulls all of the moisture out of the chicken. Just so you know, I wash my hands between each segment. I'm just not showing that, so I just don't want you to think I'm just skipping from segment to segment, but each segment I'm washing my hands. But you just pat that dry, and there's still a salt there. You still see some salt. You transfer that over. Transfer this over here. Transfer that over there as well. Move that to the side. And then I'm gonna pat that dry as well. You want it to get dry because when you roast this chicken, this is where you want that crispy feel and taste on the chicken. And that's one of the tricks that a lot of people don't tell you about. So you gotta pat it dry after now that salt has taken everything out of the chicken. And this chicken is ready to go for a marinade bath, which is gonna happen. And this marinade that I just made, I showed you the steps before, is gonna be on here for a good 2 to 4 hours. It's really depending on how much time you got. If you have time, do it overnight, more flavor. If you don't have time, a good hour and a half to 2 hours will get you a great amount of flavor, and we'll take it from there. Live and Let Die. That was a good one. We're gonna keep going with the next segment. Now we're preparing the bean and corn salsa. So I already have in my leg set. You know I like my pies. You take onions. Those onions in there. Garlic. I'm gonna put the segments and the amounts of the garlic and stuff in the recipe in the video. And then you have your two seasonings, which I'm gonna also list these in there as well. put that in there. And you just let this go in here. And for those of you who are fans, you know what this is called. This is called the fine. You want to break this down. Don't cook it too much. I'm going to turn the stove down a little bit. And you just let that break down. And man, the smell is unbelievable. And now that it's popping pretty good, I'm now going to take the black beans and drop those in there. These are Goya beans. Some people could use different beans, but these are just off the shelf at your local grocery store, whether it be Whole Foods or Publix or whatever it may be. But you put those beans in there, and we're gonna let this simmer down and break down this whole experience. And then we're gonna take the roasted corn that you see here. And I actually roasted this corn on the grill down at my spot. And you can see, so this corn has actually been prepared and roasted on the grill. You'll see it in the video on the takeaway. Just pop that in there too. So this is the roasted corn that goes along with the black beans. And man, when you taste this on top of the polenta and the roasted chicken, the flavoring is spectacular. So you see it split kind of on two sides of the pan. I'm gonna just mix it all together. And we're gonna let this simmer a good 15, 20 minutes and break down. I got it on 3. And I didn't put any salt or anything in this because there's been salt along the way, so I don't wanna oversalt the dish. But we'll put that in there and let that break down. See you in the next segment. Alright, so Duran Duran had a nice little segment in the whole James Bond run. A lot of people have been eating off of that brand for a long time. And that's not a bad thing. That's a good thing. But this was a view to a kiss. So we're going to do this Swiss chard. Swiss chard is kind of like collard greens, but it comes from the beets family. If you look in here and you see the veins of the Swiss chard, and that's Swiss, like Switzerland, and chard, C-H-A-R-D. It's a leafy thing. It has a nice feel, like collard greens, but it's not. We have to chop this down, and I'm gonna put it in this bowl. I'm just gonna use the magic of technology, and I'm gonna cut it up. And when you see it, poof, it's gonna be there. I wish you could be a part of the segments when it wasn't, like, there's music playing between each segment. This is a great song. For Your Eyes Only. Remember that one? So we're gonna cook this Swiss chard. I'm just gonna go ahead and drop it in this pot. And it's popping. That pot, that pan is already going. Pop it around a little bit. We'll put some olive oil in it on top of it just to break that down. And Swiss chard is, look it up, Swiss chard. Look it up. It's actually in the family of beets. It's in the beet family and not the, I thought it was more in the collard green family. It's not. In the beets family. Great vegetable, nice flavor, and the complimentary thing that it adds to this is unbelievable. So we're gonna season that up and get that ready to go. And you'll see how we pull this all together at the end. You don't wanna break it down too much where it takes all the vitamins and all the things out of it, but you do wanna cook it. You do want to break it down, so you'll see the next step. So, all right, so another one of these layers, because this is a little bit complicated, is the polenta. So come on in. With the polenta, we're going to do 5 cups of water. Right? You got 5 cups of water. You got 1.5 cups of milk. And you're gonna let that heat up. I'm gonna let that heat up for a while. Didn't have this on. And let that heat up. Once that's heated in a nice way, I'm gonna keep whisking it just to go. And then I'm gonna take the polenta and I'm gonna rain that in to the milk and the water. And what I mean by raining that in is to reduce the level of like getting clumps and things like that. For those of you who cook, you don't want clumps like making gravy and bad clumps. You have to wait for this element to come in. So let this warm up. And then once I add the polenta, I'll whisk it all together to reduce the level of clump. But the way to do that is let the water and the milk get warm and hot first, and then you rein it in. And when I say rein it in, I'm talking about like you at the club when we do it, like that. I ain't been in one of them strip clubs in a long time. It's never been one of my favorite places, but we're gonna make it rain. Just think of that when you do that, you're gonna make it rain, but put that in last, because it'll clump up if you don't. But that's the process. So the water and the milk is in there. We're gonna add the polenta. We're gonna stir that in and whisk it in. And that'll be the polenta, and that goes on the bottom of the dish with all the other elements, and you'll see that soon. All right. So come back in with this polenta mix. The water and the milk has been gone, and now I'm about to make it rain. And I ain't talking about the club. This particular song from the James Bond thing is Tina Turner. Tina Turner had a run with this. Tina Turner got her little ride in it. And what I mean by making it rain, just to come back to the recipe, is this. You want to break this up and spread it around within the pot so it doesn't clump up. So you just kind of sprinkle it on there. I'm making it rain right now. That is making it rain. And then you stir it up as it's going in there so it doesn't clump up. Because if you don't do that, it's gonna clump up. Shout out to Tina Turner. Always loved her. Big fan. Wonderful woman. A great representative of culture and life and history, and a powerful, strong African-American woman that just did it on her terms when she had the chance to. So, but we making it rain for Tina right now. Man, the smell of this is unbelievable. Now I see why the Ritz-Carlton charges so much for this meal. The steps are important, but when you get to the finished product, oh man, I'm getting excited about what it's going to be. I made friends with the chef there. I can't tell him that he told me the recipe, but I'll just say that we're gonna keep it moving. Okay. So, I know you know about this particular song, and actually Kanye West took it and made his own little track to it, but we're gonna go back to this next step. The host of the show is the roasted chicken. That's been sitting in the marinade for 2.5 hours. Like I said, if you want to do it for 24 hours, you can do so. I set the oven at 450, so it's preset. That oven is set at 450. I'm going to roast it at 450 for about 20 to 25 minutes and get this nice brown and dry that and get a nice crispy skin on it. So I'm going to put that in here. Okay. put here. We gonna put there for 20 to 25 minutes, and we'll show you that finished product in a little bit. All right, so come on. The polenta is done. I've been whisking it. I'm gonna go ahead and add this butter. Because the consistency is there. It's really basically grits. I mean, you could probably use grits, but polenta is the way to go, I think. Because it has a corn feel and it matches up with the other thing. You just keep whisking that. I turned the stove off just to reduce the heat. I'm just gonna let that come down and simmer. And that's gonna be at the foundation when you plate up. I'm actually gonna do it in a bowl. But you do that on the bottom. But you want a certain level of thickness, but that's ready to go. All right. Man, we are now here at the finished product. Shirley Bassey, who many of you may not know, was an African-American woman that was really the soundtrack for the James Bond film episode. And that's her. That's Shirley Bassey. So, all right, so now this is it. I'm gonna put it all together and plate it up. But we still gotta get the music to get it going. So, in the spirit of what we were talking about with James Bond, we have the celebrity of the night, the roasted chicken. We have the polenta, we have the Swiss chard, and we have the black bean and corn. And then we have the nice little finishing that you wanna see here. We're gonna put all that recipe at the end. The chimichurri, we'll sprinkle that on the top. So here's how you plate it up. I've actually cut this chicken already. I'm gonna put the polenta first on the bottom. Turn that down just a little bit. Put the polenta on the bottom. And you want a safe place to land for the meal. And then we're gonna take that Swiss chard and put that right on top. And then we're gonna go with the black beans and corn. Oh man, it smells, you have no idea how good this smells right now. Put that on there and plate it up. Then I'm gonna put the leg on the bottom. I'm gonna put the breast on an angle on the top, like that. And then I'm gonna take this chimichurri that I had left over and just put a little bit of that on the top. Just to freshen it up and lighten the flavor. And oh my goodness, if you can smell this, it is delectable. So that's pretty much the James Bond 007 roasted chicken inspired by the Ritz-Carlton in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, finished product. And I'm gonna just go ahead and take a piece. I don't even know where to cut, but I'm gonna start with a little piece of this chicken. It's so juicy. I want that skin. Oops. That is the chicken. It's so good. Let me go ahead and take a little bit of this black bean in the winter. Excellent. Until the next episode, all I can say is live, love, and laugh. And keep getting inspired by the chefs. I just love to cook. I think it's one of the best experiences we can have in life. So enjoy yourself until I see you next time. Make sure you subscribe. Just click the button on the bottom. I'm gonna be doing videos. I don't even know yet. I'm just having fun with it. So, but subscribe. And then every time I publish one, you'll see it. Until next time, enjoy.